Speaking to you from the Pianic Studios, right in front of Center, where Mr. Edward Curtis, who is instructor in pianos here and at Peabody High School, is going to teach me how to use a potted tree. And I've been watching Ed, and it looks real easy when you do it. I've honestly never done this. And when you see what I do, you know. Well, you give me a little instruction, we'll see what happens.
All right, you'll find that you'll enjoy it regardless, because it has a kind of a hypnotic effect if you don't go to sleep before you get your pot done. Yes. If you need the water, keep it moist all the time. You probably notice that. And you'll have to exert quite a bit of pressure and keep the speed up on it. Start your cooking there today.
Keep
it going counterclockwise.
Counterclockwise.
Yes. Fast? Yes, fast as the clock here. Yes.
Now,
and then add the water with the sponge and keep it moist and try to get this ball of clay to rise fairly
in the center of the wheel.
Now you'll have to exert a little more pressure by lifting your arm and give it some support and use a little more moisture while you're doing it. And a little more pressure from the side. Perhaps if you get your hand across the top, you can exert a better pressure from the side.
Like this?
Yes. Now this is the arm that does the driving, natural. Oh, you'd be a natural here. This is your chance to literally go to pot. There you go. There you go.
I don't know what I'm trying to do here. Am I getting it right?
Yeah, so far it's got a little wiggle in there. It's not quite center. This is probably like a lot of wiggle to avoid that center issue. You got it. That's it. Now, put a little more pressure down in here. That doesn't wiggle. You're following the thing a little too much. You're not putting enough force against the piece. You're letting it push you. That's the way. See?
I don't know what your tongue has to do. It's not even your mouth that right there. Yeah, I'm getting something coming out there that doesn't look right.
Well, probably. I think from what I've seen so far, at least with a little practice, you'd be able to catch on pretty well. And if nothing else, you go out of here with a well-developed left leg. Anyway.
I was about to comment on that little idea. Do you ever work on a right leg table any time? Just
so I guess that would be simple. Otherwise, you'd get a little overbearing on one side. It still has a little bit of a wiggle. It's one of those things that look very simple when someone else does it. It's just a matter of applying the motor skill. Once you've...
it's using exactly the same. Well, where do you go from there? If I was centered, then what would it?
Then you start an opening here by touching down, detecting the center of the pot. Yes. And here again, you have to rest your arm. It's one of the important things in learning to draw pot. You can't let the clay push you around. You have to be master at all times here. That's the idea. Push down. With the tips of your fingers a little more. That's it.
Oh, hit bottom.
you'll have a bottomless pot. That'd be good for any kind of an ashtray for people that want to quit smoking or something.
What I'm making is a funnel. Funnel. I didn't start out to make a clay funnel, but that's what I wound up with.
Generally, these first two steps beginners get quite rapidly with a little practice, so a little more than what you've given it, and then after this, you can, with some a little more practice, you can apply this skill.
Let me rest my leg, and then you tell me where, supposing I was right.
Then you start the raising part, which means getting your hands inside and out, and sitting down at this wall, which is not there. Well, and try to tie your hands together to work in unison.
That's it. You're going over the pot in. Now, this this is going to be a museum piece to me.
it's very rare that anybody will show something in a free form on a pottery wheel, you know.
Your description is being like time. It's about a 1/16 of an inch down here and about an inch up here, and it's getting wider all the time.
Well, so there you're kind of helping gravity and centrifugal force along right there. The nature of the clay is wonderful. I think it's just a matter of learning to master it and getting the feel of it. It does take time. I think for your first pioneering attempt here, you did very well.
Well, I think we better not press our luck any further.